together as one, cause divided we're none. Ready to go, we feel the flow, so don't stand in our way, you know we ain't afraid. This is our time, we're in control, we might trip up today.
What's up everyone, NeoCypher here, getting back to Yu-Gi-Oh! Legacy of the Duelist Link Evolution. And we are winding down Zexal. We have just six more duels to go here. And we are starting off the week with a Sea of Troubles, which apparently is in the middle of an ocean. Not really a sea, but sure. Oh, and apparently Rio has some sort of power. Okay. You learn a lot about these characters in like the last third of the game, or series, or however you want to word it. And it looks like a elemental hero Bubble Man grew up a bit. And we have someone else who can apparently shapeshift. Or take over someone's soul? Body? You know, pick power that villain in previous series had and insert it here. Do not believe we've ever dueled Rio, so I have no clue what kind of deck she uses. We're gonna find out though, because she decided to go first. Black Ray Lancer. Let's see. Once per turn, you can detach one of these monsters from tear off of his card to target one piece of monster in the field, negates effects until the end phase. It's not bad. If I could somehow exceed someone on turn one. Then that would be negated, my attack would become zero. What we got here though? Shark stickers. Okay. So actually I can. Cause I have a water monster. Oh, fish sea serpent aqua. That's a fish. That's aqua. This control, so that's already overturned. Okay. Okay, and what is the Bubble Bringer? Level 4 or higher monsters can attack directly. During your turn, you can send this face up card from the field to the graveyard to target two level 3 or lower water monsters with the same name in your graveyard. That's some of them, okay? First, we're going Mystical Space Typhoon, whatever's in the back row. Call it a haunted. I mean, everyone has called a haunted. Guess if I do this correctly, then. Mm-hmm. Trying to think though, what I could do. I just do this. This is gonna be weird. Trying to think, it'd be more damage if I exceed summoned, but didn't have to use material to get rid of that or to negate its effect. Let's actually do this. Let's go to battle. Go to main two and exceed summon. So yeah, I'm only dealing 300 damage overall instead of 900. But this way I don't have to waste an exceed material when I first summon it. I don't know why I put it there. Ceiling light. Sword card during the second stand by phase after activation. Once card resolves, change all your opponent's all monsters your opponent controls to face down defense position. Your opponent can't. Monsters your opponent controls. Oh. Oh boy. Okay, that actually somewhat helps. Zexal haunted. I'll do this then. Summon you. Now we can flip summon this. Probably gonna lose a bit of attack here, or a bit of life, but yep, 800, so I'm gonna lose two. Let's go to main two. Activate the effect, switch out defense mode. Cool. Oh, crap. I hit B. I thought it was going to ask me to activate the effect of a card. I did want to reduce the level of all fish by one, but oops. Mm-hmm. I'm not going to attack twice, so this may still work out. Let's go into phase for now. I'm going to hold on to the swords. Her spell, or her face down, does not apparently affect my ability to attack. Nothing. Increase the levels of all the three fish that monsters control by one. Okay, that's increase. That's not level three. Or that's not fish. Alright, so this should be it then, because I can attack twice. So, in case you're wondering why I went lowest to highest there, it's just in case it would have had anything that could have negated an attack, and they were saving it for the Mike Sees monster. Basically, in case it could somehow negate the attack to end the turn, they probably would have done it first, but I don't know how the AI works in this exactly. Yeah, please don't leave. There's so many unanswered questions about this entire series. Yes, the number that we never even saw. So we've unlocked the next campaign duel, World of Chaos. The reverse duel for Sea of Troubles. The Rio deck avatar. The Gorgonic Mermail deck recipe, which we never really saw get off the ground. The Frog Metamorphosis Challenge Deck. Number 73, Abyss Splash, which I'll take a look at since we never got to see it. Mermail Abyss Lung, Organic Ghoul, and 1162 Victory Duel Points. So we got 100 for the win, 16 for the returns, 2 for spells, 15 for no traps, 4 for Sea Summons, 31 for difference in life points, and 10 for inflicting battle damage only for 178. And I meant to go see what that number did. My bad. Into it. Frame. Seize monster. Number 73. There we go. 2 level 5 water monsters. Once per turn during either player's turn, you can detach 1 exceeds material from this card, double this card's attack until the end of your opponent's turn. Also, any battle damage it inflicts to your opponent this turn is halved. Not bad. Okay, that was a frog. For a minute, I thought that was like a birthday cake or something. It's overall not too bad. So, that is it for this video. We are pretty much into the final 5 duels now. So with that, I hope you guys are enjoying the project so far. I thank you for watching, and I will see you next time. Halfway to forever.